Today we are going to learn about the continuous casting process, and why continuous casting process is preferable over traditional casting process. In the traditional casting process, the raw materials are charged in batches in a furnace, where it becomes molten metal. The accumulated liquid metal is tapped and cast in molds. Disadvantages of this traditional method are addressed in the continuous casting process. Introduction. What is a continuous casting process? Continuous casting, also known as strand casting, it is the process where molten metal is solidified into billets, slabs, and blooms. Sir Henry Bessemer received a patent in 1857 for casting metal between two counter-rotating rollers. But this method wasn't introduced until 1950s in the industries because of many technical problems. Before 1950s, steel was poured into stationary molds to form ingots. Since then, continuous casting has evolved to achieve improved yield, quality, productivity, and cost efficiency. Continuous casting process can be used to cast steel, aluminium, copper, and other special alloys. The basic outline of this system has recently been implemented today in the casting of steel strips. Various obtainable shapes. Continuous casting is used to mass produce basic metals into long, semi-finished shapes with constant cross-section, such as rectangular, square, circular, and dog bone shapes for I-beams, and even thin strip, rod, and other products. Difference between continuous casting and conventional processes. Continuous casting is distinguished from other solidification processes by its steady state appearance. That is, the molten metal freezes against the mold walls and is withdrawn from the bottom of the mold. Continuous casting is the most efficient way to solidify large volumes of metal into simple shapes with consistent quality. Compared with other casting processes, continuous casting generally has a higher capital cost, but lower operating cost. Continuous casting process produces near net shapes that are closer to the final product shape, so it require less subsequent deformation. This makes continuous casting more energy and cost efficient than alternative processes. Basic elements of the continuous casting process. Furnace, to melt the desired metal into the liquid molten metal. Ladle, to transfer molten metal to tundish. Tundish, to hold molten metal and to distribute molten metal to mold. Mold, to direct the molten liquid into the required shape, and cool molten metal to some pre-specified temperature. Mold oscillator, oscillates the mold to prevent the metal sticking to the mold walls. Cooling system, to lower temperature so that the molten metal solidifies. It is divided into two stages, primary cooling system within the mold, and secondary cooling system at rollers. Support rollers. They are used to maintain the structural integrity of the strand. And finally, cut-off tool. To cut the output strand to predetermined metallurgical lengths. Now, as we know the basic elements of continuous casting process, let's understand the working. Here, I'm choosing vertical downward continuous casting process to explain. vertical downward continuous casting process. Molten metal in furnace is tapped into the ladle. At the correct predetermined temperature of the metal, the ladle is transported to the top of the continuous casting machine. Usually two or more ladles are used on a single casting machine. The purpose is to provide sufficient continuous supply of molten liquid metal. From the ladle, the hot metal is transferred through a refractory pipe to a holding bath called a tundish. The tundish allows a reservoir of metal to feed the casting machine. Tundish acts as a buffer of hot metal, as well as smoothing outflow, regulating metal feed to the molds. Metal is drained from the tundish through another refractory pipe into the top of an open base mold. The depth of the mold can range from 0.5 meter to 2 meters, depending on the casting speed and section size. The mold is water-cooled to solidify the hot metal directly in contact with it. This is the primary cooling process. Mold oscillates vertically to prevent the metal sticking to the mold walls. A lubricant is added to the metal in the mold to prevent sticking and to trap any slag particles. In the mold, a thin shell of metal next to the mold wall solidifies before the middle section, now it is called a strand, exits the base of the mold into a spray chamber. The bulk of metal within the walls of the strand is still molten. The strand is immediately supported by closely spaced, water-cooled rollers which support the walls of the strand against the ferrostatic pressure of the still solidifying liquid within the strand. To increase the rate of solidification, the strand is sprayed with large amounts of water as it passes through the spray chamber. This is the secondary cooling process. Final solidification of the strand may take place after the strand has exited the spray chamber. Various types of continuous casting process. There are four types of continuous casting processes. They are as follows: vertical, horizontal, curved, and strip continuous casting. The design of continuous casting machines may vary, but almost all the variations are very similar. Vertical continuous casting, it is again subdivided into two types. They are vertical downward continuous casting and vertical upward continuous casting. As the metal flows down in vertical continuous casting, solidification of the alloy occurs. Curved continuous casting, if the strand in the vertical continuous casting is bent slightly at the cut-off side, it is known as curved continuous casting. Horizontal continuous casting, if the system is set horizontally, it is known as horizontal continuous casting. Molten metal is directed in horizontal direction and thus, output is also obtained in horizontal direction. And finally, strip continuous casting. In the strip continuous casting, the output obtained is in the form of strips, by applying the load on the strand at the rollers. The casting technique is determined by the alloy or type of metal you want to cast in the continuous casting process. The size of the strand or strip you want to produce also plays a role in determining the type of casting technique. Some other reasons are the availability of floor space, the scale of production, the capital investment or initial setup cost, maintenance cost or working cost, etc. Advantages of continuous casting process. 100% casting yield. Cheaper to produce ingots. Better surface finish. grain structure can be regulated. Process is automatic, requires less labor. Higher casting speed. Limitations of continuous casting process. Understanding and controlling the casting process is important, because it may introduce defects that persist into the final product, even after many later processing steps. Improvements to continuous casting must be cost-efficient, owing to economic pressure from the general oversupply of primary metals in the world. In addition to expensive plant experiments, understanding comes from physical water models and advanced computational models. Continuous and capable cooling of mold is required. Large capital investment. Not suitable for small-scale production. Require large ground space. Applications. Long billets of various cross sections can be obtained, such as round, square, hexagonal, gear-toothed. Solid and hollow ingots can be made. Bushing and pump gears. Production of copper, brass, and bronze, bar, tubes, and wires. And other cross sections. Subscribe for more engineering concepts. Thanks for watching, and happy learning.